Hi everyone, this is Dinesh with the Firewall Business Unit, and I'll walk you through the SD-WAN Wizard, which is the new feature introduced in Cisco Secure Firewall 7.6.0. This release introduces a simplified and automated guided wizard for the route-based hub-and-spoke topology in an SD-WAN deployment. This greatly reduces time and complexity by providing you a new SD-WAN wizard, which provides you multiple benefits. To start with, it automates a lot of configuration parameters like virtual tunnel interface creation, the IP address assignment for the spoke virtual tunnel interfaces, and additionally, it automates the tunnel interface configuration, the VPN authentication, and overlay routing parameters. This feature also simplifies all of the configuration in a single page for the administrators to configure the components and provides you bulk addition of spokes as well. In terms of configuration, there are four steps to this SD-WAN wizard. In the first step, we configure the hub devices, where we configure a single or a dual hub. Additionally, we configure the dynamic virtual tunnel interfaces and the IP address pools for the spoke tunnels. The dynamic virtual tunnel interfaces and the BGP overlay configuration parameters are auto-populated by the wizard. In the second step, we define the devices we want to use for the spoke and the associated VPN interface selection. In this step, a lot of parameters are automated in terms of the IP address assignment, the bulk spoke addition, and auto-generating the unique local tunnel ID for the spokes. The next step is authentication, where we configure the pre-shared key or the certificate-based authentication. This step also automates the configuration for the pre-shared key and selects the IKE and the IPsec policies and can be changed if required. And lastly, in the step 4, we configure SD-WAN settings, where we define the security zone for the spoke tunnel interface along with the overlay routing configuration using the BGP. So let's take a look at what are the enhancements done within the SD-WAN wizard. One of the key considerations in the SD-WAN topology is to allow spoke-to-spoke communication. To implement this without requiring full mesh connectivity, the wizard brings in the support for the route reflector. This allows the hub to be configured as a route reflector while the spokes are configured as route reflector clients. The wizard also brings in the support for the AS override. This feature allows the spokes in one AS to learn the routes of spokes in the same AS connected to a hub in different AS, that is spoke 1 talking to spoke 2. This also allows spokes in one AS to learn the routes of spokes in different AS connected to a hub within their own AS, that is spoke 1 talking to spoke 3 or spoke 4. Let's take an example using scenario 1, assuming hub 1 is down and spoke 1 wants to communicate with spoke 2 via the hub 2. In this case, spoke 1 intends to learn routes of spoke 2, but due to the same AS number in the AS path, the routes will not be installed. The AS override feature addresses this challenge by replacing the AS number of the originating router with the AS number of the sending BGP router. To use this feature, the Firewall Management Center requires 7.6, while the Firewall Threat Defense devices require 7.6 for the hub devices and 7.3 and above for the spoke devices. There are no additional licenses except the export control license for the VPN tunnels, and FTDs must have an internet routable public IP address. Ensure that you assign appropriate logical names and IP addresses to the interfaces and enroll the certificates on the hub and spoke if planning to use certificate-based authentication. In this demonstration, we'll take a look at a dual hub and spoke deployment within the same AS number, all using dual ISP. We have outside one interfaces configured on all the hub and the spoke devices along with the outside two, and we will leverage loopback interfaces for sourcing the tunnels. Let's log in into the FMC and navigate to devices, site to site, and create the first topology. So we give the topology a name, topology one, and click create. Step one is where we add the hub devices. So we select hub one and create a dynamic virtual tunnel interface. Notice how most of the attributes are pre-configured. So now we'll create a loopback interface from where the DVTI will borrow the IP address. Once it's created, click OK. Now we configure and review hub gateway IP address, which is taken from the tunnel source. Let's create an IPv4 pool, which will be used by the hub to issue the IP addresses to the tunnel interfaces on the spokes. Similarly, add hub number 2 and create a dynamic virtual tunnel interface. This is also sourced from the outside one interface, and now we create a loopback interface. So now we create another pool for the hub 2 to issue the IP addresses to the spokes. So we notice that the hub 1 is set as primary hub in this topology. So now we click on add spokes, and we can add spokes in bulk or individually as well. So let's go and add the spokes in bulk. So we select all the spokes, and now we use tunnel interface by the virtue of the interface name pattern that is outside one. We can also use security zone. So we review the tunnel interfaces, click add, and this shows the local tunnel Ike identity configured for those tunnel interfaces on the spokes. So let's click next and we configure the pre-shirt key. Notice that it also shows you the transform set and the IQ2 policies for the tunnels. So now we create a manual pre-shirt key and click next. And with this, we go to the step 4, which is SD-WAN settings. So the first step is we configure the tunnel interface security zone, which will be used within the access control policy. Then we enable BGP and configure AS and community tag for the advertised routes, and also enable redistribute connected interfaces. Notice that the enabled multiple path for BGP is already enabled to allow the traffic to be load balanced across multiple links. So we click next and review all the parameters for the topology one and click finish. Similarly, we create topology number 2. Now this topology is based on all the devices communicating on the outside 2 interface. So we select the hub 1 and source the dynamic VTI via the outside 2 interface. We create loopback interface from where the DVTI can borrow the IP. And review the hub gateway IP address and create tunnel pool to push the IPs to the spoke virtual tunnel interfaces. Similarly, we add hub 2 and create a corresponding dynamic virtual tunnel interface sourced from the outside 2 interface. We also create a corresponding loopback interface for this DVTI. We also add the hub pool IP address. Now that both the hubs have been configured, we make hub 2 as the primary hub for this topology number 2. So let's click next and add spokes. So we select all the spokes, click add, and now the tunnel source will be based off of outside 2 interface. Once the spokes are added and the local IKE identities are created, we go to step 3 and create manual pre-shared key. And lastly, we select the tunnel interface security zone and enable BGP as the overlay routing protocol, where we configure the community tag and enable the redistribute connected interfaces. So this shows us the holistic view of the topology too, with all the dynamic virtual tunnel interfaces. And we deploy this configuration. Now that the configuration has been deployed, refresh the page and notice all the tunnels are up. So within the topology one, notice that the hub one has 4 tunnels to all the spokes using the outside one interface. And likewise, hub 2 has tunnels to all the spokes using outside one interface. The only difference in the topology 2 is the tunnel source on both the hub 1 and hub 2 and the spokes is using outside 2 interface instead of outside 1 interface. We can also edit the topology to look at the generated tunnel interfaces. So we click on edit, click view generated interface, and we notice that the spokes are connected to multiple hubs and have corresponding static virtual tunnel interfaces. So with this, we go to the overview SD-WAN summary dashboard and look at the VPN topology, and let's expand on that. So this takes us to the site-to-site VPN dashboard. So let's focus on the tunnel between hub 1 and spoke 1.1. So we click on eye icon, click on CLI details, maximize view, and this gives us information about the encapsulation and the decapsulation counters for the tunnels. And we notice that the incaps and decaps show that the traffic is going through the tunnel. So now we go to devices, device management, and we can also see the tunnel interfaces configured within the devices. So we go to the hub one, click on virtual tunnels, and notice that the virtual template has the corresponding virtual access interfaces going to all the spoke devices. Similarly, the virtual template 2 also has associated virtual access interfaces from the hub 1 going to all the spokes. Let's take a look at the spoke and click on virtual tunnels and notice that it shows all the tunnel interface associated to the spoke. So now let's click on edit and go to the device CLI for the hub 1 to look at the overlay routing configuration. So we run the command show run router BGP. This shows us all the BGP configuration that is pushed by the virtue of the SD-WAN wizard. And notice all the neighbor commands that are created automatically through this wizard for the spokes. This configuration also has route maps within the BGP configuration. So let's take a look at that. This command shows us all the associated route maps on the hub devices. And let's take a look at the BGP pairing. So show BGP summary shows us that the hub has multiple BGP neighbors that are based off of multiple spoke devices configured within the SD-WAN wizard. And this concludes our demo, and I hope this was informative.